Look, I think, you know, for me to look back on it, it's quite funny now, but I remember I'd gone from the Logies where I didn't think anything had happened. It was just like a normal show, apart from being a post-Logie show. And it wasn't any different to any other year. Like, we all got, you know, smashed at the Logies and go to work the next day, and we'd done it for years and years. But, you know, I think this was the first Logies where stuff was really working on the internet. And this happened between 5:30 and 6, so no one was watching at that hour anyway. So between 5:30 and 6, that's when they got everything. And it wasn't until 3 days later that I'd been off working on a 60 Minutes tour that I started copying these calls from people saying, mate, you're on Today Tonight. You know, I've gone, what for? And they go, you know, for being drunk at the Logies. I said, well, you know, what do you mean drunk at the Logies? Like, who wasn't? And then I remember it being on Today Tonight and just going, oh, God, you know. And when I looked at it, I really was drunk, you know. I certainly looked and sounded drunk, which meant I probably was still drunk. but I think, you know, I was worried about it initially, but then I think, you know, the public sort of just thought, well, you know what, I think he's done what everyone's done, and I think that broke down a barrier for me in a way of people just going, you know what, I think, you know, if he's prepared to go to work and, you know, he hasn't killed anyone, you know, it's that age old theory in TV that if I haven't really harmed someone, then the public might find it funny. And the public have been tremendously supportive of it. The only drama is that every time I go out now, everyone wants me to get drunk with them. Or if you get invited to a function, they say, can we have a drunk, Carl? I'm quite boring otherwise. That's the thing. And, you know, and I think certainly that, you know, people often said after I won that Logie and that Channel 9 had that good campaign with Hugh Jackman, everyone goes, well, there was a campaign, there were viral campaigns, it was the first time that was really done. And I think at the end of the day, though, people have still got to vote for you. So whoever wins it, the most amount of people have voted for them. So, you know, whether you deserve it, I mean, who knows? Like, I think people can be really a little bit too serious about all this stuff, but at the end of the day, it's just a bit of fun, I reckon. And the campaigns were, I think, really good fun. I've never worried about criticism. You can't. I mean, if you look at Twitter, it can be a small number of people making a very big noise. And you can't take any offence at all of that. I mean, on any given day on the Today Show, you know, and if people watch the whole show, they'd know that there's serious interviews, there's light stuff, and there's mayhem. And I think that I can cross over and do 60 Minutes and do good stories in this standalone, irrespective of what people think of me and what. You know, people like to put people in categories. That's up to other people. But for me, it's always been about variety and being able to transition between, you know, light stuff and heavier stuff. And I think that I do a good, decent job of that. And the stories speak for themselves. I'm not worried about what people say on Twitter. You know, otherwise I wouldn't be on Twitter. You know, because you can cop a caning. Well, I think, you know, I think that any guy that gets into their 30s. Any person for that matter will get to a point where they go, you know what, I'm not the healthiest. And the problem was that I was getting up at 3:30 in the morning, you know, I wasn't eating right, and I was, you know, having 8 cups of coffee, and you just get into this rhythm of bad behaviour and bad habits in terms of what you're eating, and go home and sleep for 2 hours, and so then I decided, right, I've got to do something about this, because I'm mentally tired all the time. And so to get mentally fit, you have to get, I think, physically fit as well. So I just changed everything, and now I try and get out every day after the show and do exercise. It clears my head, which is really important. And, you know, I think that you've got to do everything you can. If you're doing breakfast TV, you've got to do everything you can to try and keep as fit as you can. Because otherwise, if you get really mentally tired, then it starts to show on air and you start to make mistakes. And I just needed to make a decision about that. You know, I lost a fair bit of weight, and I just got fit. I've been able to maintain it, which is important to me. It was the Elvis years, though. I think I was 93 kilos. I was having deep fried peanut butter and banana sandwiches every day. It was magnificent. I miss those days. From a career perspective, I would say the most important thing is when you start out, in no matter what field you're in, for me it was journalism, just to work really hard and to listen to people who are experienced in the business. Get as much work experience as you can while you're at university or whatever school you're at, to learn the craft. But, you know, once you get out there and you've been lucky enough to get a job, to get there first, you know, when you go into a business like journalism, you're not going to get the best story of the day. The most experienced journo will get the best story of the day. But if you get in there first, if you get in at 6 a.m., an hour before everyone else gets there, then eventually the chief of staff will have no choice but to give you the best story of the day, because the most experienced journo won't be up until 9 o'clock. So, you know, I've always found get in there first and go home last is a great philosophy. And I've always worked hard like that. And that's how, you know, I started getting ahead in the business, getting great stories and getting experience, great stories. So work really hard. I think it's important to play hard as well. You know, I think if you work really hard, and especially when you're young, then give yourself a break on a Friday night and go and get smashed. But always try and get to bed before 1 o'clock in the morning. Because there's no good that has ever happened to me after 1 o'clock in the morning. It's all bad. Go hard, go home at one. That's my philosophy on life. Unless you're in Ibiza.